In a day, these two men teach children how to play the saxophone. And after work, they try to sell their beloved instrument online. In fact, these guys are surrounded by saxophones all day long, every single day of the year.
基本上家家户户都能做这个东西，他培养了好几代人，每一代就是老人、孩子。
我再给你们讲，知道吗？
This small town in northern China is known for making saxophones. You probably can tell just by this big statue standing at the entrance. Sidangkou Village is home to only 2,200 people. But word from local officials is that 80% of them work in the wind instrument industry.
咱们这个斯当口出这个乐器啊，占全国的80%，
基本上是欧美市场、亚洲市场，包括南非几乎都覆盖。
The village is started with instrument factories, small and big, but things are much slower due to the pandemic. Kids at school have to learn at least one wind instrument, whether they like it or not.How did a small rural town become the saxophone capital of China? In the 1970s, they used to specialize in making saxophone keys, which were then sold to instrument factories in northern China. But when the country's economy took off in the 90s, the companies privatized and realized they could make more money by making the whole instrument themselves.
2000年转型干的乐器，
拿个样品把它拆开做成模具自己再生产，这路线话说在十年前吧，很多时候吧就是光制造乐器，而且呢不知道自己的乐器啊是否从音准呐、手感呐各方面音色呀有什么好坏，
所以说我们在经过老师结合我们整个一个团队也经过半年的时间，我们在反来覆去的去修理。
Eventually, they got the hang of it.
乐器这个产业还是一个传统的一个人靠人工去组装的一个乐器，它的整个一个说流水线，整个一个机械制造方面还是很小的，主要是靠人工去完成，还是形成不了一个像自行车啊，像什么电子元件这流水线的这个生产。它是一个老式的一个工艺。
At a factory, everything is made from scratch. Every worker does one task over and over again. Parts are molded, pressed, punched out, soldered, and assembled from scratch.
其实我们没有什么大学生，都是农村人出身。
An experienced worker makes about 15,000 renminbi a month, twice as much as what a factory worker on the electronics assembly line in Shenzhen earns.
我们上次在2005年的时候已经批量生产了，后来慢慢的提升，开始几百只一个月，后来1000只，我们最高峰的时候做过1600-700只。主要是还是销往国外，
无论是工艺加工、制作、通材、音准、材质方面的音色都达到标准了。
Today, the village has 26 manufacturers. Other than saxophones, they also produce brass instruments like the trumpets and the tuba, and the cases that come with them. Production used to be driven by orders from overseas. Now they are getting more inquiries from local retailers.
我叫张斌，现在从事小学的音乐老师，然后平时的网上销一些乐器，搞一下直播。现在咱们国内的话，份额就能占到50%-60%。像在咱们这种直播带货呀，厂家直销啊，会很好很好。只要有专业的人在这里。给你讲解，卖的就会很多很多。
之前呢，只是制作啊，没有是设身到吹演奏。后来经过这个我们董事长，再加市里老师这个专业培训， 当然就也算我们算业余的，老师是专业的，逐渐的会吹乐器，掌握了乐器的音准音色啊，能知道它的感觉，断断续续一周一个月四节课，那、有时有工作一忙了就没有时间练习了。目前断断就是整体的队伍当中，主导的有差不多10个左右。
Children growing up seeing saxophones everywhere in this village. School children are enrolled in mandatory music classes. Some are inspired to take their lessons further.
想考到音乐学院，当一个音乐家。
But not every kid is impressed.
我们村呢就是一个乐器的产地，学生们也不是说这么认学吧。他毕竟不会想到，哎，我们这就生产这个东西，我们每个人都想吹怎么着。他现在还没有看到外面的世界是怎么样子的了。
Hey guys, did you know that Goldthread puts out a free newsletter once a week with information that we don't publish anywhere else? It's got interesting links, what's buzzing in China, and it's the first place we tell you about giveaways whenever we have them. Click the link in description to subscribe right now.